Welcome back. It's your Racer X Films preview show for the 2014 Monster Energy Supercross Championship. Jason Weigandt and Steve Matthes here. We are now going to break down a trio of riders who invented an all-new category of racer last season. It's a category called, I cannot believe effing fill in the blank is in sixth place, and I'm a factory rider, and I can't catch him. I'm talking about three riders who did this routinely last year. Matt Goerke, Phil Nicoletti, and Weston Peick. They elevated their games heavily in 2013, and a lot of really fast riders who would normally beat them could not beat them. But sometimes people get carried away when that happens and think, well, if they got this much better from 12 to 13, and they improve that much again, they're going to win races the next year. Are they going to be that good?
No. No, but good job to all three guys. Mm-hmm. I think Weston Peick is certainly somebody to cheer for. And I think Matt Goerke is had his best year going until he broke his wrist. Ask Rick Johnson. Wrist injuries are tricky.
He's still struggling a little bit.
Still struggling with the wrist. Yeah, I don't think RJ is really going to do much in 2014.
Oh, RJ.
Yeah,
I really don't think so. 50 years old, too.
Oh, Goerke.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Goerke, I think he is a little bit, and I think it's going to be tough to get back to the level he was at, but he was certainly impressive. This is a guy who showed up 2 years ago with sexy devil gear from Germany with nothing and worked his ass off to get to where he is right now, and good job on that.
Yeah.
When Weston Peick isn't kicking bikes off stands, he's riding very well.
I think kicking bikes off stands is a great thing. It shows how bad the guy wants it. He was battling for a position in the main event, didn't get it. I would rather see the guy emotionally pissed about not making it than, what am I going to do? I'll see you next week.
As a former mechanic, I didn't like that. That's abuse of a motorcycle. Treat the motorcycle nice, it will treat you nice.
Teams, you're not trying to sell bikes to former factory mechanics. You're trying to sell to fans of racing that would be very proud to see a rider
try that hard. Hey, screw you, mechanic. Oof, I'm going to kick a bike off stand.
Hey, they don't need to keep the bike running. He's not even in the main event that night. Okay, our last rider on this list is Phil Nicoletti. That's a very complicated deal, the level of support he has this year. Pike's going to be a privateer again with a little more help from Suzuki.
I prefer the term for Nicoletti.
Yeah?
I prefer the term game changer.
Yes, but will that be a good game? Let's go to our man Jason Thomas. He's been in the shoes of these riders before as a privateer. And you mentioned that sexy devil gear before. He's looking good himself. Let's go to JT live in Boise, Idaho.
So last year we had three guys that kind of stepped up and really made a name for themselves. Probably had the best year of their careers in Matt Goerke, Phil Nicoletti, and Weston Peick. They were in the top 10 a lot, and I know going into next year a lot of guys have questions if they're going to be able to follow that up. They can even take another step higher and start to beat on that top five door. My opinion is they're nearing the ceiling. I think that they're capable of getting in that fifth or sixth spot, but as deep as the field is, unless guys start getting hurt, really don't know how much more they have left in them. You start running out of talent at some point. But, I mean, obviously in today's field, if you're getting fifth place or sixth place or seventh place, that's really, really good. So I think if that's their goal and that's what they can pull off, then they have to look at that as being successful.
Okay, that's JT's take on these guys. And I think he's right. Top five, we're not saying that these are not great riders. We're just saying that to get top five is right. Very difficult. Last year, seventh was the best finish of the year for both Goerke and Peick, and a tenth for Nicoletti. Now, that deal for Nicoletti, just give the basics here of what you call a game changer.
Folks, Corey Gibbs, he's no idiot. He's an innovator. And what basically they've done is Corey Gibbs and the JGR Yamaha crew tired of finding replacement riders. Phil Nicoletti needing a ride for 2014. Loved the bike, tested it, thought it was great. Yamaha was on board. Corey Gibbs has hired Phil Nicoletti. He's only guaranteed six races.
Three indoors, three out. Yep.
And if something happens via injury, or I've been told, if someone's not performing and Phil is riding during the week and doing his job, a rider could get benched and Nicoletti could move into the JGR squad. Corey Gibbs, innovation at all times. But let's get to our man Jason Thomas, who not a fan of this deal. And let's get his take on what he thinks about this.
So this Phil Nicoletti deal, I'm still confused. Matthes and Weigandt, I know you guys are pretty close to the situation, but six races out of 29 where he has a guaranteed deal, it doesn't seem like a real smart move on Phil's part. I don't know all the details to it, but I do know that part. And for me, I've been in Phil's situation a lot. I don't think that I could do that. I would just want to be at all the races. I would want to build that momentum throughout the series. And obviously, we're all in this, you know, racing to make money. So still has me a little bit puzzled. Maybe it'll work out. And I'll look stupid, but right now I'm not a big fan.
Okay, that's what JT thinks. First of all, I'm going to make a not bold prediction here. In fact, this isn't bold. This is normal. This is something I can guarantee. Nobody's getting benched. It's not happening. No one is going. Grant and Brayton are not getting benched.
Okay, I guess. Yep. All right. We'll see. I'm not saying the benching is going to happen. I'm not saying that.
You shouldn't.
I'm saying there is a chance.
There is no chance.
There's a chance of benching.
Steve, you've been around this sport a long time. We know the world revolves around the riders. Every team has to prove to every rider, even if they don't like that rider, that they're doing everything they possibly can to give the rider the best support possible. If a team were to go to the point where they actually say, we don't even want you to race this weekend, we're giving somebody else the bike, it's over. That rider is done. He will quit on the team. They have essentially quit on him. It does not happen.
We'll see, Weege. Coy Gibbs could be starting a new trend here with a reserve rider. It happens in F1. It happens in NASCAR. He's got a reserve rider, Filthy Phil Nicoletti, who's, by the way, making a little bit of a salary. Happy to do this. He's got a full works bike, full testing procedures and everything. And I'm a fan of Phil Nicoletti. And I think perhaps, we will see Nicoletti on the JGR team for much more than three races indoors.
All right, well then let's get a little vision of the future. Let's get a little vision of the future. That is the key. Three races indoors, three races out. That's not a lot. So you're saying we will, oh, you have a vision. We're gonna see Phil Nicoletti in a lot more than the guaranteed minimum of six?
I see Josh Grant getting injured. Perhaps Justin Brayton. I see Phil Nicoletti 12 Supercrosses.
Wow, 12 just in Supercross alone.
And 12.
Wow.
Coy Gibbs, I believe in you.
Coy, somebody's got to. That's it for our trio of I cannot believe this effing fill-in-the-blank is going so fast that I can't beat him. We'll see you next time.